There is no Bitcoin company. There is no Bitcoin building. There's even not even a Bitcoin server anywhere that you could shut down. It is completely distributed. That's what's unique about Bitcoin. It is, for the first time, a way for the two of us to exchange value online without a third-party intermediary. Until the invention of Bitcoin, for you and me to exchange money online, we had to employ a third party, like PayPal, like Visa, like MasterCard.
Well, Bitcoin is exciting because it shows how cheap it can be. Bitcoin is better than currency in that you don't have to be physically in the same place. And of course, for large transactions, currency can get pretty inconvenient. The customers we're talking about aren't trying to be anonymous. You know, they're willing to be known. So the Bitcoin technology is key, and you could add to it or you could build a similar technology where there's enough attribution that people feel comfortable. This has nothing to do with terrorism or any type of money laundering.
About it earlier, but Bitcoin and things like it is the equivalent of the red pill. Okay? We are entering a completely world of uncharted water
right
now.
Have you made any investments in Bitcoin?
So, I mean, I personally, I own Bitcoin in my hedge fund. I own Bitcoin in my fund. I own Bitcoin in my private account. It is a huge deal. It's a huge, huge, huge deal. Because what you're talking about right now is, for the next 3 to 5 years, an unbelievably better store of value. It is gold 2.0, right? The value of gold that hedges the world economy about $9 trillion, right? $1,300 an ounce, of which only $100 to $150 is the actual production value. So all the rest of it is imputed, where, Lena, you and I have decided that it's worth $1,300 an ounce. Well, guess what? I can do the same thing with Bitcoin, except now I can do it outside the purview of every single government. It's being used everywhere where you would think it would be used. Russia, Iran, Iraq, Egypt, Venezuela, Argentina, everywhere where you have currency pressure, everywhere where you want to basically shield your assets. And then after that, it'll probably become a payment mechanism. So in all of these three industries, you're talking about trillions of dollars up for grabs. Up for grabs.
But right? Bitcoin, I'm still predicting Bitcoin, $10,000 per Bitcoin in 3 years. It's a hedge against a lot of fiat currencies. It's a new way of transferring cash throughout the world in a much more efficient way. And Bitcoin has created a whole infrastructure of many, many companies, some of which came out of Boost, the incubator. Mm-hmm. And those companies are creating this whole new culture, this whole new way of thinking.
Bitcoin trading at 1,000, 2,000, 5,000, 10,000. Rick Falkvigna does an excellent analysis. He predicts that Bitcoin will capture between 1 and 10% of the global Forex market, which implies a price of between $100,000 to $1 million per Bitcoin. Most of the people who are on the sidelines not buying Bitcoin today will start to buy Bitcoin when it gets over 1,000. And then a greater percentage of people will definitely plow into Bitcoin when it starts to get over 10,000.
Currency of the future, or is it the payment system they're developing?
Bingo, it's the payment system. It's the blockchain encryption. And there are interesting things. I think Bitcoin, or the really blockchain encryption that's behind it, has a greater ability to bring more of the world's population out of poverty than anything we've seen in...
For one thing, it's a cheap payment system.
But it's more important than that. Blockchain cryptography is all about digital transfer of ownership in a completely transparent and public
Bitcoin
way.
Bitcoin is something that you've been interested in and supportive of. In fact, one can pay for a tour on Virgin Galactic up to the moon with Bitcoin. I think the Winklevoss twins have said that they would do exactly that. You think this is a currency that's really going to work eventually?
Well, I think it is working, and there will be other currencies like it that may be even better. But in the meantime, there's a big industry around Bitcoin. Mm-hmm. You know, people have made fortunes out of Bitcoin. Some people have lost money out of Bitcoin.
Well, it must be POW. People don't know. So I suggest that everyone go back to buy one Bitcoin. Not too much. Only one is enough. If everyone is worth it, people, just to go back buy one Bitcoin, you know, the Bitcoin value go to the $1 million. When the Bitcoin have $1 million, you know, the all around the world will be crazy, and everyone will be the follow, and other digital currency just be, you know, be grandson of the Bitcoin. So for me, I think for a lot of people, they don't exactly understand why it's Bitcoin. They're trying to find out Bitcoin maybe is expensive. Well, I find out another way. I'm doing my coin. I'm doing the new thing. But I think, okay, you just stop that there. Go back. The Bitcoin will be the great in the future.
Is Bitcoin just for sort of people doing illicit things in the dark side of the internet, like the Silk Road types?
No, it's not just for that. I think that's a definite piece of what Bitcoin allows, and so of course this is why law enforcement regulators are interested in addressing that. But right now you have Microsoft, Dell, you have the United Way, the Red Cross, thousands of other merchants who accept Bitcoin. And I think, again, more than just payments, in the future we're going to see cross-border settlement of different kinds of accounts. We're going to see different kinds of microtransactions that weren't possible before. It's not just about the dark web, it's about the future of commerce. I think it's going to grow in value over time simply because the use of the technology is going to grow. And there's a fixed supply of Bitcoins. And so as a result, I think the value is going to grow.
Bitcoin as a currency on the internet, peer-to-peer, managed by the participants in it, is the perfect libertarian solution to the money enigma.